Hello Gundam fans, this is Brom92, and today I'll be looking at the SD Cross Silhouette Zeta Gundam Clear Color version. So I got this for my birthday, along with the high-grade RX-78-2 Revive color version. But unlike that kit, and a lot of kits that are clear, especially the white, is usually a milky white. It's not completely clear, but this guy is. He looks more like a crystal. Which I much prefer. I wish all clear colored variants were like this. I think the Blitz that I got before, which was all clear, I think it was the same. So I'm not really sure why SDs are like that. I think Master Grades might be like that too. For some reason, High Grades, they use the Milky White, which it's okay, but I'd rather have this. And I did use the stickers. So we got the metallic cameras and the eyes. Unfortunately, the ones on the legs and the ones on the backpack are just a regular matte sticker. I really wish they were metallic. Granted, they would have to change the stickers, but it just looked better with the clear. Also, the gray for the backpack, the hands, and the arms are more of a gunmetal. Although, the cross silhouette inner frame, which is what you get in the kit, unlike other cross silhouette models, including the Zeta, which you get the SD inner frame, you have to buy the cross silhouette separately. You don't have to here. But if you prefer the SD inner frame, you're going to have to get it with another kit, because this only comes with the cross silhouette. But this is really the first time I can ever say, like, you can see an inner frame with an SD. Like, whoever thought we'd be able to do that? So it is very cool. Definitely does look nice being able to see the inner frame inside the armor. You can also see the Z on the forehead. I didn't use the eye stickers on the other side, which are the pupils, because I would never use them, and it would look a little weird seeing eyes on the back of the head. Articulation is still the same as before, which is really good. My only advice would be not to do too much with the waist. Like, you can rotate it, but if you want to pull it out to use the ball joint, be careful, because I am worried about the clear cracking where the ball joint goes in. Also, the side skirts are pegged in, but once again, it's all clear, so be careful. But everything else is the inner frame, which is not clear, so the armor here should be okay. It's not very tight. But yeah, everything else should be okay. And of course you have the shield, which does look nice. Just paste onto the arm there. And then you have the gunmetal beam rifle. And then, now this is the one time where I don't mind having a beam saber toothpick, because it is clear, so it's not like having just a stick. So it doesn't look too bad. If you really want, you can always take a like clear paint. I don't think there's clear pink. Maybe there is. Or there is a pink Gundam marker, like a felted one. You could probably make it light pink. Or just use a red Sharpie if you really want to do that. But I do like it. I don't have a problem with the clear beam saber, even though it's just completely clear. And that is it. It's just the same as the other one. It just got a lot of clear. So let's do a comparison with the original. So you can see, yeah, same thing. And once again, the gray, you can see it's more of a gunmetal on here. It's not very noticeable, but it is a little different. It's kind of like a speckle. You can kind of see it on the arm and the gun. So it is different. So yeah, if you can find it, which I got it for like $20, which is, I think, pretty good for an SD. Like, for a clear variant anyways, because the SDs are usually like, in Canadian, like, I think 12? 10 to 12 for the cross silhouette. So I don't have a problem paying that for the clear. I wouldn't mind getting other ones in the clear variant. I don't know if there are any other ones. I'll have to look. Anyways, that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.